crossroads. Morgan brought me here while showing me the alluvians.
It's pretty, I guess. Kind of stretchy. Ugh. Too many colors.
Everything looks gray and murky to me.
But there's patterns all over. It's like glass from, where's it? Sorol, isn't it?
I wonder if it somehow looks different to elves.
How would that work? Eyes are eyes, or supposed to be. Oh, stupid place.
Judging by the bloodstains, he tried to get through here.
What's wrong? That one doesn't like you?
This mirror doesn't look broken, but it's inactive. Maybe there's a way to unlock it. Blood trail leads to this mirror.
Right. Let's see where this guy came from.
Out here.
Elven ruins. I'm not sure we're even in Orlais anymore. Another Canari, dressed like the one in the Winter Palace.
He's Karashok, a foot soldier.
Oh, this is gonna be fun. The old team together again to kick some ass.
There's no throwing, right?
It was one time.
Looking for ruins and dead people. Why do I keep coming back for trips like this?
I'd guess the Sparkling Company and your continued contribution to it. I could be wrong.
Ugh.
Scorch marks everywhere. This is the work of a mage.
A powerful one. I can still feel the heat crackling.
We need to find out why these Canari were here, and who did this to them. Over there, Canari. If we want to know why they're here, we've got to get across to that island.
The elves bound a spirit here. It feels old. Very old.
What does it want?
Nuvenas menahelanin. Tiath belasama.
We're visitors. We didn't mean to disturb you.
Vithama. Nadinan salim.
Thank you. that spirit considered us intruders.
Maybe it's all the intruding we did? When we intruded?
It must have been set to guard something. That was like veil fire. It claimed this was a refuge for elven slaves.
Slaves? Of other elves? The old elves? Pissers.
This whole valley was a sanctuary, created by the dread wolf Fenharel.
Fenharel? The Dalish elves' god of misfortune.
Letter by the Canary. Why are they translating it into our language? That alluvion only took us a short distance. That's the same lake we saw from the other tower.
Good for moving around a city, visiting friends, deploying guards. Cuts all over the back. He was killed by surprise.
This can't have happened too long ago. The blood's not even dry.
Here we go again. What a change of pace from the Winter Palace. A clear sky, a beautiful view, and yes, fields and fields of stripweed as far as the eye can see.
Stripweed?
Terrible stuff. Looks like grass, stings like a knife, and causes sores if you so much as brush against it. So, of course, everyone in Manrathus insists it makes a very decent tea.
This is Fenharel helping former slaves as a mortal, not a god.
Kinda curious that this guy had to specify he wasn't a god.
But Fenny helping is bonkers.
Fenharel sounds like quite the rebel. The old elven gods must have simply loved that.
The elven gods were just Evanuris, powerful but completely mortal mages.
Ah! Are you hurt?
The anchor flared up. It's fine now.
This place is creepy.
This looks like it fits into that pedestal by the broken bridge. Canary.
Bashidan, the Inquisition doesn't leave alive.
Thank you.
Why did those Canari attack the Inquisition on sight?
No idea. They weren't Talvashoth, though. This might be a rogue group, but they think they're following the cube.
That's Fenharel, removing the face markings from a Dalish elf.
Not Dalish. They weren't Dalish yet, right?
Maybe the markings used to have a different meaning. What's this? Hidden weapons. These freed slaves actually fought back against the Evanuris, posing as gods.
Interesting word, Evanuris. If all it means is mage leader, well, they were basically magisters.
The Dalish are going to shit themselves.
This letter says the Qunari came to these ruins because the Illuvians connect to Halam Shiral.
So they're aiming for the Winter Palace.
It was some sort of infiltration. There's no more details.
This is crazy. They're acting like we're at war.
Are they?
I don't know, boss. I wish I did.
Let's look for anything that explains why the Qunari came here before we go. A note about an unknown intruder coming through an Illuvian. They turned spirits against us, then fled.
It must be a mage. They killed any Qunari in the way and let the spirits do the rest.
Two parties, then. The Qunari and a mystery agent determined to stop them. Come on. We have to warn people about the Qunari's designs on the Winter Palace.
One dead Qunari was bad enough. Now we have more, and they're hostile.
This makes no sense. The Qunari may not be friendly to the Inquisition, but they have no reason to attack us.
They also have no reason to be here, or using Illuvians at all.
I've had the mirror placed under guard for now.
I just wanted the Exalted Council to go smoothly.
We must ensure that the Qunari do not disrupt the negotiations. The Exalted Council is in a very delicate state.
I'm certain you can soothe the nobles' ruffled feathers while we solve the real problem.
Not when the Inquisitor insults everyone present by walking out in the middle of the talks. Our only advantage is that Orle and Ferelden are divided in goal and grievance. If they unite against us, Divine Victoria will have no choice but to support their claims. We could lose everything.
I know we're asking a lot of you, Ambassador. I promise we won't make this any harder for you than necessary.
My apologies. I will attend to the Exalted Council.
And while Josie does that, we will investigate.
I'll head back to the crossroads. We need to find out what the Qunari are doing, and why they attacked.
And I'll have a quiet word with our honor guard.